And welcome back to Proactive Investors. Here with me today from Provaris Energy is CEO and Managing Director Martin Carolan. Martin, good to have you on the program with us today.
Thanks, Alicia. Good to be here.
So, Martin, you're here today to break down the new H2LEO compressed hydrogen storage technology for us. Give us a rundown on what this technology does.
Yeah, so the H2LEO is a floating storage solution for hydrogen in the form of compression, which is our specialisation. It's based on the successful development so far of our H2NEO compressed shipping solution. And so what it's going to do is provide you a much needed, you know, low cost, effective and efficient solution for the hydrogen sector overall. So it will have a design capacity of 300 to 600 tonnes. As you'd be aware, our H2NEO ship is 430 tonnes. So it will have great flexibility and add certain requirements for the sector. So we have received an approval in principle from the American Bureau of Shipping, which is our marine classification partner. And so what that means is that it meets the essential design principles. We've completed key initial safety studies and hazard studies, so we know that it will be effective in that part. The H2LEO will provide efficiencies to our own compressed hydrogen projects in terms of buffer storage and intermittent storage applications. And it can also then have a benefit on reducing the levelized cost or the delivered cost of hydrogen. So we see it as a certainly important part of our own supply chain. And then more importantly, we'll have various applications across the industry, whether it's bunkering solutions for maritime sector, intermittent buffering storage for other hydrogen vectors. And then overall, it could be used for long duration storage applications, which add flexibility to the overall power network.
This sounds like an extension of your existing plans to compress, store and transport natural hydrogen. Can you walk me through how this approval in principle opens up further opportunities for you and the team?
Yeah, well, in the last 18 months, we've been asked many times, could we convert our shipping solution into a static storage solution for onshore? Just sheer weight requirements of steel for safety reasons is the limitation and the expense factor that you've seen in onshore solutions. So by putting it into a floating structure, it extends the IP that we have and provides a number of new business opportunities for our company as well.
Let's break down the economic side now. If we're looking at the capital costs that are estimated for this kind of solution, they're comfortably lower than the comparative onshore solution. Can you walk me through why that is?
Well, I guess to move what we've seen to provide this level of storage onshore, the industry hasn't been able to come up with cost-effective solutions. So just purely the amount of steel that's required to store a compressed hydrogen gas at that volume and certain pressures. So there's been a number of containerized solutions, which have a bottle solution or a cylinder solution. So onshore storage at this scale is quite limited in its opportunity. So bulk scale is what's required. So if you move that into a floating structure, we can reduce the number of engineering points that are required in an onshore basis. And then just purely the fact of what we've just designed in our own shipping solution extends to a floating structure. So if we can add a solution which has significant cost benefits, that's going to help the overall hydrogen economy as it develops globally.
So really, just summing up here, this sounds like it's a solution about creating a more efficient way to transport a burgeoning commodity to market, if you will. Martin, what are the next steps for this technology?
Yeah, so we will now run it in parallel with the final development stages of our shipping program. So it will benefit from the feed level design package that we have done on our shipping solution. We're targeting for it to be included in our prototype and testing processes later this year and into next year. And we see that there's an opportunity perhaps for a smaller scale storage for your floating solution to be available by 2025. So it could be the first commercialization event for the company, and whether that's involved in our own compressed project, whether it be in Australia or up here in Europe, or whether we make that available to another vector such as ammonia. So We think it advances the company, it shortens the time frame, and perhaps puts one unit into production versus a fleet of ships, as we're looking to do with our projects. So the final stages of design and testing will take place over the next 12 months, and then look to produce a first unit in 2024 for production in 2025.
Interesting to hear about the horizon here. Martin, we thank you for bringing us up to speed on this latest technology. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Alicia.